Good afternoon. So last class we talked about the lesson. So that is early nationalist, partition of Bengal and assertive nationalist. So these are the topics which we discussed in the, the previous classes. Almost now in, the first phase of the national movement, we have talked, the two lessons. So that is the first war of Indian independence and the nationalism. Then in second phase of Indian national movement, we already talked the three incidents. So one is that is early nationalist groups. Then we have talked to partition of Bengal. Then also we have discussed or we have talked about the assertive nationalist. So before we go into the Indian national movement, the third phase, that is of Gandhiji's national movement in India, we are having one more the topic, so which we call it as a formation and objectives of Muslim League. This is the sixth chapter. Okay, the formation and objectives of Muslim League. Okay, one more the political party. So before we get into the formation and objectives of Muslim League, today's class just I want to give you introduction. So how this the Muslim League formation started, what are the reason behind the formation of this Muslim League? So that we are going to see in today's class. When we see in the introduction, it is being said that a communal alienation, okay, communal alienation, okay, the Muslims felt there is a communal alienation in India. That means Muslims are isolated by, okay, by British as well as by an Indians, that is Hinduism group. So that feel, the feel of isolation or feel of alienation started to take place among the Muslims. Okay, so in order to come out of this alienation or communal alienation, so Muslim, in India, or the Muslims in India, they felt that they also need a political party like INC. That was the first. The second one is Hindu-Muslim unity against a common enemy. Okay, the common enemy for Hindu and the Muslims were in India was that is, British. Okay, so British. Hindu-Muslim unity, the unity of this both, so felt that common enemy to them was British. And if the fight towards the British to Hinduism, there is INC. But what about the Muslims? There was a question mark. So that is the reason the Muslim few eminent the Muslim leaders they felt how there is a INC for Hinduism or Hindus in India. Same way we also need a one political party for an Muslims in India. So that was also a one reason. Then policy of divide and rule policy. Okay, the policy of divide and rule. So the last policy implemented by Anna, British. This is policy is implemented by Anna, British. Okay, so policy itself says divide and rule. This policy was implemented by Anna, British on the Hindus and the Muslims. So they implemented this policy on them. The impact was, the impact was Hindu-Muslims fight. They started to have fight each other instead of concentrating on the, sending British out of India, they themselves started to fight each other. So that is the divide and rule policy. Okay, so this is some general fact or general concept which is there for the formation of, Muslim League. But now here, there are some reasons. Okay, there are some reasons which Muslims felt. Okay, Muslims felt we need to have an formation of one political party to an the Islamic people. So in that first reason is one is lack of education. So basically, the Muslims lacked in education. Okay, like Asgar Sahed Ahmad Khan and Ali brothers. So like that, many eminent leaders are there. They felt that Muslims should be imparted an education. If the Muslims wanted to be given education, that education, a start of or the establish of the educational institution, so that can take place only with the political party. And to start an educational institution for the Muslims, we Muslims leaders cannot approach INC. Okay, when Muslims approach INC, because INC is a political party dominated by an Hinduism, I mean when it was dominated by an Hinduism leader, so Muslims leaders felt that it won't work when we demand INC to start for the, I mean to start the Islamic institution for the education to the Muslims. So that is the reason they themselves felt in order to give an education to the Muslims, so we need to have a political party. So that is the one thing. Okay, that's one reason. Then second one is loss of Muslim sovereignty. Okay, past Islamic people started to go the past of India before the arrival of British. Okay, before the arrival of British. Okay, before the arrival of British, India was ruled by whom? It was all the Muslims from the time of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, from the time of Delhi Sultanate till the British entry, our country was ruled by the Muslim rulers. Okay, that's sovereignty. Okay, that the prestige to the Muslims, they wanted it back again to Islamic people in India. So that is the one thing. Then a communal tinge in history writing. So some of the historians, they wrote history of India. In that they expressed the communal tinge. Here communal tinge means the religion based on the caste, their history they started to write. So in that one is they divided Indian history into Muslims period and as well as the Hindus period. So Muslims period, Muslims were called as the rulers and Hinduism were called as the subordinates. Okay, subordinates. They are the subordinates to the rulers. There was no problem in that. But when they wrote the Hindus period history, Hindus were rulers, but Muslims were called as foreign invaders. So this, considering the Muslims as the foreign, invaders, it hurt the Muslims people in history writing. Okay, that was the one reason which we had. And a religious tinge in expression. Okay, so national movement when it was started or when we started to fight against the British, so here what happened in the India, in the national movement, we started giving examples. Now, for example, you can see, so Ganapati festival was celebrated and Shivaji festival was celebrated and Rana Pratap, okay, the ruler, about him. The inspiration and the inspiration was given through these people, both in the Ganapati festival, Shivaji festival, and Rana Pratap. Then now the question is, what about Akbar? What about Sher Shah Suri? What about these people? Are they not the good rulers or good administrators in India? They are. But we did not give the examples. So Hinduism leaders, they started to represent in the Indian national movement only of the Hindu religion, but not the Muslim. So that also made one of the reason for the formation of Muslim League. And the last one is economic backwardness. So since Muslims were having a lack in education, so they were not allotted the government jobs, or they are not given any representation in the British government. So basically, their poverty was seen, and economically, the Islamic people in India, they were completely backward. So, in order to gain all this, Okay, so in order to gain all this, so Islamic people, they felt the political party is required. So this all made the formation of political party or formation of Muslim League.
So now we will see so how the Muslim League was formed. So when we see the formation, before I go to the formation, we are having an introduction. The introduction, if you see, I mean, to curb the influence of INC. So Muslim leaders also felt, the attitude of the British people in India is on favor of INC. That means on favor of Hinduism. So that is the reason, in order to curb the influence of INC in India, the influence of Hinduism in India, so the Muslim League, formation also, took place. Then another thing is separatist, tendency. Okay, the Muslim leaders also had their demands and opinions, but they felt that expressing an opinions and demands to the INC, to the British people, it is not a favor towards the Muslims. So that is the reason, in order to express their own separate tendencies. Yeah, tendency is nothing but their opinions and demands. Okay, their demands and their opinions towards the Muslims. So they felt that they need a political formation. So with all these things, so in 1906. So in 1906, in Dhaka, that is in Dhaka. Bangladesh, in Dhaka, Bangladesh, the one conference was made. The conference name was Mohammedan, educational conference was conducted by the eminent leaders of Muslims. So in that one was, Nawab Salimullah. So he is the person who was the eminent presiding officer to this particular Mohammedan educational conference. So at the end of the conference on 30th December, so 1906, one more political party, it was organized in India. So that party was called as, that is All India Muslim League. Okay, so was founded. Okay, 30th December 1906, the founder was called as Nawab Salimullah. Basically, he was a king. So he was king of, Bangladesh. So he was a king. Later on, he turned into the politician and he founded this, usually All India Muslim League. So this is the second oldest political party in India. 1906 onwards, so it started to function so in India. But shortly, we call it as a Muslim League. The founder is Nawab Salimullah, and it was founded in Mohammed Educational Conference, the session in Dhaka. Okay. So later on, it was to be dominated. So now how INC was dominated by the leaders like early nationalists, the Sarin, so like that. So the people who were dominating this All India Muslim League were, one is Nawabs. Nawabs are nothing but kings. They are called as kings. Okay, Nawabs and landlords, that is Zamindars. So they are the people. Then Ulemas, that is Muslims nobles. Okay, Muslims nobles. So these three people started to dominate, this Muslim League. So that's how the formation, took place, in 1906. So 30th December 1906 onwards, the Muslim League started to function, in India. So next class, we will see their objectives and some of the impacts, all these things, we will see it in the next class. So till here, you can, go through. So very important is, 30th December 1906, All India Muslim League, under the leadership of Nawab Salimullah, under the Mohammed Educational Conference in Dhaka, so Muslim League, All India Muslim League was established. So this is very important, so you should know it. So next class is a very important topic, that is objectives of Muslim League and its impact of Muslim League. We'll see in the next class. Thank you.